question for you. What's your password for the site?
Whoa! Wait, no, stop!
You weren't actually supposed to answer that. It was a test.
Never give anybody your password. Each of your online accounts is like a bank vault full of valuable information, memories, and sometimes even money. You should keep your vaults locked up tight because there are some very shady people out there who want to break in and steal everything inside. Stick around and find out how you can use extra layers of security to keep out any intruders who might want to break into your digital vaults. Let's get into it. Before we get into the extra security features you can use to protect your accounts, let's talk about the first line of defense, the door to your vault, your password. Or should I say passwords, plural, because you should really have different passwords for every account. Remember, we're talking about how to keep hackers out. Why do you think it's dangerous to use the same password for everything? If you use the same password everywhere, then a hacker who figures out your password to one account will have your password for every single account you have. By using different passwords everywhere, you keep any security breaches contained to just that one account. But the goal is to never have even a single security breach, right? And that means not only having different passwords, but having strong passwords, so that hackers can't figure out even a single one. Let's go through a few rules for making strong passwords. Do any of your current passwords contain any of these? First rule for a strong password: avoid using anything similar to these as your password. These are the most commonly used passwords in the world, and they're the first thing hackers are going to try. We can only fit so many on the screen right now, but you can find a longer list in your PDF for this lesson. You should also avoid using easily guessable information as your password. Things like the name of your pet, your birthday, your favorite sports team. Really, you know, any basic information somebody could learn about you with a little snooping. For instance, it would be a really bad idea if I use Mia Academy as my password because anybody that knows where I work would be able to guess it. Finally, the longer and more complicated your password is, the harder it is for anybody to figure it out. Okay, so let's do a little math here. Let's say you want a password that's super easy to remember, so you use only lowercase letters, and you make it short, only 4 characters long. In this case, there are only about 460,000 possible passwords you could make. Hackers have programs that can guess 5 million passwords per second. So it would take them less than a second to crack your password. You might as well not even have a password at all. But what if we make it more complex? Let's include some numbers and uppercase letters in our password. Even with just a short 4-character password, there are now almost 15 million passwords this could be, which would take 3 whole seconds to hack into. Ugh. Still not much, but we're getting there. Okay, so now let's make our password longer, 8 characters. With lowercase letters, uppercase letters, and numbers, a hacker will now have to try, let's see, that's about 218 trillion. Wow. That's a lot of passwords that a hacker would have to run through. It would take them 505 days to get through them all. That's almost a year and a half. You could even make your password more complicated by making it even longer and including symbols. Good luck to any hacker trying to guess my password out of 37 nonillion possibilities. As you saw, complex passwords are harder to crack. This is why many websites require that your password meet certain criteria for length and characters. It can be super irritating trying to meet all these criteria when making a password, but I promise you, it's for a good reason: to make it almost impossible for intruders to get in. But what if your password isn't quite as secure as you think? Or a hacker just happens to get lucky.
Some websites use security questions as a second layer of security. These are questions that other people wouldn't know the answers to unless they know you really well. Things like, what street did you grow up on? What was the name of your third grade teacher? What is your favorite author's childhood pet's uncle's favorite color?
I don't even know the answer to that last one. Security questions are meant to be answerable only by you, not a hacker. But what if a hacker has done their homework and knows everything about you? Is there no way to stop them?
Sure there is. That's where two-factor authentication comes in.
Two-factor authentication, or 2FA for short, is kind of like the series of fingerprint scanners, cameras, and lasers that bank robbers have to get past before they can finally get to the gold inside the vault.
2FA requires you to use two factors to log in. Something that you know, like your password or answers to security questions, is usually the first factor. But the other factor has to be either something that you have or something that you are. The something you have factor requires that you prove that you have a specific object in order to log in. Most people's object is a phone with a specific phone number. When you want to log into your account, a one-time passcode will be sent via text, and you enter that code to prove that you have the device it was sent to. The only way a hacker could get through this second factor is if, in addition to figuring out your password, they also have some way to intercept your texts. Or instead of something you have, the second factor could be something you are, as in your own body is what you use to log in. It sounds weird, but you've probably seen it in movies before. Fingerprint scans, retinal scans, and facial recognition are all examples. These body scan authentications are known as biometrics. If you use this as one of your two factors, the only way a hacker can get into your account is if they've stolen your finger, your face, or your eyeball.
Ew.
Ugh.
What if you have a strong password, security questions, and two-factor authentication, but your account still gets hacked? Well, in that case, the most important thing is locking the hackers out of your account again and stopping them from using any information they stole.
The first thing you should do to lock them out again is change your password immediately so the hacker loses access. If, against my advice, you used that same password for other accounts as well, change those passwords too. Next, think about what information the intruder might have stolen. Did you have payment details, such as a credit card stored in the account? If so, contact the related financial institution and let them know that you've been compromised. They'll cancel your card so the hacker can't use it, then send you a new one. If the account contained any sensitive personal information, like your social security number, contact your country's consumer protection agency to report that your identity may have been stolen. Finally, watch for any strange activity on your account that you don't think was done by you. If things seem to be happening on their own, change your password again. In today's digital age, we spend a lot of time online and make a lot of friends online. In fact, that's where I first met Mia. But it's not uncommon to also encounter hackers, scammers, and other bad people who pretend to be your friend until they get what they want from you. Be careful when making friends online because you never know who they really are behind the screen. In the next lesson, you'll learn the do's and don'ts of making friends online safely. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.